Good morning, everybody. Theo, the Juggernaut. Hope all the wonderful dads out there had a great happy Father's Day yesterday. Seems like a lot of the action for the Bombers and the Jets happened on Saturday. We'll get to that to a second. As well, our Goldeyes, they kind of had a pretty good tilt with St. Paul, losing quickly, unfortunately, a close one, 7-6 yesterday. But let's quickly touch on our Winnipeg Jets. They had to finalize their protected list on Saturday, 3 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Pacific, or 2 p.m. Central, 12 p.m. Pacific, yada, yada, yada. The Vegas Golden Knights now have all rosters set aside for them, and they are now on the pickings of what they want to do with their team. Some great names are out there, including James Neal. Toby Enstrom could be available as well. Ha-ha. He did waive his no-trade clause for the Winnipeg Jets in good faith, hoping to be around with the team next year. We don't know what's going to happen. I mean, the GMs have been told by the NHL, keep your mouth shut until Wednesday. No signing trades, no nothing, no leaking any information out, if you will, because they want to make it a huge spectacle for Wednesday and the Las Vegas new team. Having that said, what are they going to do? Well, New York's already decided to not give up a player and instead give them a first-round draft pick. Who knows if that'll work? But like we said, all things will fall on Wednesday when Vegas can start picking and choosing who they want and who they don't want. As for our Jets, a lot of them are protected. The good ones are protected. Some of the names that are out there, the younger ones, well, they could go, they couldn't go. It all depends on how Vegas and some of their coaching staff wants to move. They could take a player like Andrew Kopp. They couldn't. They could take a veteran like Toby Enstrom. They couldn't. Maybe they've got something set up with Downer, even though he already just recently signed a one-year $850 with the Jets, and maybe that might be a sign and trade. Who knows? But we'll wait and see. We'll see what happens on Wednesday. I'm not going to speculate. I don't speculate. I tell the truth, Ruth. Speaking of the truth, 46 players on the roster for our Winnipeg Blue Bombers as of Saturday. Some notables, some not notables. The bottom line is they still haven't fixed their defense. They have Mo Leggett listed as a linebacker, whether he plays line or secondary, regardless. He is going to be the catapult in that secondary to try to keep most of those receivers at bay. Unfortunately for him, it's only going to work if and only if Mr. 55 Westerman and his crew up front in the front four, front six, decide to put some pressure on the opposing quarterback. That's right, I've said it. I'm going to say it now before the season even starts and before all of you start whining about how our defensive backs allow receivers to get so open. Let me remind you, the CFL field is larger, it is longer, it's not the most talented players, so there's going to be people that if they run a great route as an offensive player, they are going to get open on any defensive back in the CFL, no matter who they are, unless you don't let a quarterback have more than 5 seconds to throw a ball. After 5 seconds, every DB, no matter who you are in the CFL, is at will of a long ball, of any type of ball, and a possession continuing on and a first down going on. There it is. I've said it. So, Mr. Defensive Coordinator for the Bombers, I'm going to leave you nameless right now. Quite frankly, I don't care who it is or who it are. The thing you have to fix in this first bye week is making sure you come up with a strategy that our defensive line is able to put pressure on their offensive team as much as humanly possible all the time without taking a play off. There. Done. Bombers, you're down to 46. Congratulations. Good wide receiving core, good set of QBs, couple good running backs. I don't know. Wait and see what happens July the 1st in Saskatchewan. As for our Goldeyes, like we mentioned, they were 5-5 before going into the series with St. Paul. They now sit 17-12, a game and a half back, I believe, of St. Paul Saints. They hit the Lincoln, Nebraska to take on them salty dogs. Dottie's on the mound today, this evening at 7:05. Hopefully they can pull a couple of wins together. I mean, St. Paul is atop of the Northern Division for good reason. They hit the ball well. They strategize. They strategize well. Sorry, strategize. Sound like Stratego. They strategize well. They know how to play a good run ball game. Good base, bad running. And they have some power behind the bats as well. And their pitching definitely picked up on Sunday. Like I said, it was back and forth, 3-2 after 3. Going up 3, went 6-2. And then finally, the last three innings for the Goldeyes, the pitchers held them to scoreless. 7, 8, and 9 innings. Just unfortunately, Winnipeg couldn't get the bats going again. So hopefully that better luck in Lincoln. This is Theo the Juggernaut. We'll catch back with you probably after Wednesday to see what Vegas does and their unveiling of their team and see who got prepped up from the Winnipeg Jets team. And maybe they got some more work ahead of them. After that, it'll be July 1st and frenzy free agent signings. Talk to you soon. Have a great rest of the week. Enjoy the sunshine for now.